We all remember it. It was January 15th, 2009, when US Airways Flight 1549 took off from LaGuardia Airport in New York. Its captain was Chesley B. Sullenberger III, but everyone called him Sully. There were more than 150 people on the plane. A minute and a half into the flight, a flock of birds was sucked into the engines of the plane, and Captain Sully immediately realized that his engines were dead and that the plane was now flying only on his takeoff momentum and some auxiliary power. He radioed ground control at LaGuardia Airport and told them that he needed to make an emergency landing and that he could not make it back to LaGuardia. He knew he was going to have to crash land the plane somewhere. If he tried to land on the highway, he would probably kill not only everyone on board, but many people on the ground as well. In a split second, he made the decision to land the plane on the Hudson River. He knew that in an emergency landing on water, the nose of the plane had to be up and the wings perfectly parallel. He called out to the flight attendants to tell everyone to brace for impact, made sure the wings were perfectly level, and then landed the plane on water as though he had done it hundreds of times before. All 150 passengers and all crew members were saved. What's even more incredible than this miraculous landing was what Captain Sully said months later in an interview. He was asked how he managed to keep his cool during the ordeal and make such an impossible landing. He answered, "When I was very young, my father passed away. For years after, I went through terrible emotional pain, such anguish. I thought I could not exist one day without my father. In my teen years, as I was learning how to cope with my pain, I made a promise to myself that for the rest of my life, I would try to save anyone I could from the type of anguish that I went through. Whether it was someone who experienced a loss like mine or any form of grief, I would do what I can to comfort them." Here I was, flying with a failed engine over the Hudson River with 150 passengers on board, and all I can think of was my father. I knew that if I didn't land the plane perfectly level, I would break the promise I had made to myself as a teenager. Hundreds of thousands of people will mourn for these 150 passengers. Instead of saving people from experiencing pain and loss, I would be causing them to feel the suffering that I felt when my father died. I told myself, I must land this plane perfectly. I have no choice. I had to make sure that no one goes through what I went through. There are so many people out there in pain. Through our own struggles, difficulties, and painful experiences, we can become more sensitive to someone who is sick, someone who's lost a family member, or someone who is experiencing challenges within their own family. When we see someone who is struggling with something similar to what we have been through, we have an opportunity to show our compassion and understanding and to be with them in their distress. We can share our similar experience and describe how we were able to overcome it. No one wants to feel pain or go through challenges. However, anytime we do go through something difficult, we are given the chance to use that experience to help someone else. The Almighty has given each of us the strength, courage, and fortitude to overcome our obstacles and to grow from them. We can draw on that strength to help others so that we can all lead lives that are productive, inspirational, and a blessing to those around us.